Hi everyone. Now we are going to see RC coupled amplifier and its voltage gain and frequency response. We are going to see RC coupled amplifier by using a voltage divider bias or self bias. So to see that one, actually this is diagram of RC coupled amplifier by using potential divider or voltage divider bias, self bias or universal bias, these are another names. By using that biasing, this is the circuit diagram. And the name RC coupling, that is coming based on the coupling component which one we are using, that we can see later. So take the same situation. We have seen this voltage divider bias, this circuit diagram, in the last two videos. In last two video. Then the same diagram is we are using here. R1, R1, RC, RC, VCC, VCC, R2, R2, RE, RE. Along this one, we are using some other components, that is one capacitor C1, another capacitor C2, a source, a resistor, the third capacitor CE. This is only the difference. Then what is this? Actually, the purpose of R1, R2, RC, RE, all these things we have discussed in the last video. R1 and R2 together providing a voltage divider circuit, and it is almost voltage equal to VB, that is VCC into R2 divided by R1 plus R2 to turn on this transistor. Then for that voltage we are getting a particular value of VC across this transistor. That one we have to fix. And in any situation, by increasing the voltage, increasing the temperature, if this VC, it is changing due to the changing IC, we are using RA resistance to fix that change, because when IC is increasing, voltage across RA is increasing, thereby IC will decrease. Then RC is to control the current flow through this transistor. Like that, all these resistors we have seen in the last video. Then along that one, some new compounds are here. The first one, C1 and C2. Actually, the purpose of C1 to couple the input AC signal to this DC voltage VB. Actually, what happened is this AC signal, it is somewhat here. And taking this was AC signal, then that is input Vin, and this is VB. So this is our Vin, then this is our VB. By using this C1, we are coupling these two signal, that is this AC signal will get clamped on this DC. Be somewhat like this, means AC will, its zero offset position will shift and just clamp on this DC value. Why? Because the transistor, it require 0.6 voltage across this VB to turn on, but this side, this is negative value. Then if we are giving this signal directly to here, that negative region will get cut off. That is indirectly we have seen in load line, it will goes to Q1, will goes to cutoff region, then we won't get output. This portion will be clipped. The output will be somewhat similar to a rectified signal. So from this zero point to a DC value, this VB value, we are shifting the position to coupling such this AC signal to this DC value, we are using this input coupling capacitor. Then at output side, again I told you the Q point is here. Q point means particular value of the output voltage and output current. That output voltage, I told you VC, the voltage across this transistor, collector and ground, this VC. And this amplified signal will be oscillating with respect to VC, somewhat like this. So we are getting output somewhat like this. This is actually our input. This input will become like this. From this one, actually this signal is AC plus DC. We have to take only this AC signal. We have to block this DC component. For that one, we are using this output capacitor. Output coupling capacitor. Then what will happen? At output side, we will get only the amplified AC signal. And DC will block by this one. Then we are taking that output signal across a resistor. So see, here the input is coupled by using one capacitor and output we are taking by using one capacitor resistive network. Resistor capacitor network. So coupling means we are linking these two by using a capacitor and resistor network. Since we are using resistor capacitor network to couple this circuit to input output, we are saying this is a RC coupling circuit. Then, so you now clear what is all these things. Then next one is CE. We didn't discuss about the CE. You may remember in the case of voltage divider bias, whenever there is change in increasing temperature, that will result in the increase in IC. Then that is increase in the result of IE. When IE is increasing, IERE increase, then IERE means VE. VE increase means VB is decreasing. So again, collector voltage will decrease. So actually, this is a negative feedback. By using RI resistance, we are giving a negative feedback to the input. We are giving a negative feedback to the input. So, that negative feedback should apply only to the DC signal. If it is giving negative feedback to AC signal, we won't get amplified signal, this much amplified signal. Its gain will decrease very, very small. So, this negative VB minus VBE, that negative feedback should apply only to the DC signal, not this AC signal. So this resistor should applicable to DC and not AC means we have to keep one capacitor here. So whenever AC signal comes, it will pass through this capacitor because capacitor will pass AC and block DC. So DC is supposed to pass through this resistor and AC will pass through here. So for AC, it is short circuit. And DC, it is open circuit. So that we are able to fix the Q point exact in that location by giving negative feedback to DC signal and bypassing AC signal through coupling this bypass capacitor, then that will result in the increase in the gain. Due to this reason, it is bypassing the AC signal, it is known as bypass capacitor. Then I think most of all compound we have explained here. Then how it is going to work? See, when I am giving input Vin, when I am increasing the Vin voltage, that will result in the increase in the forward bias of this emitter base junction. I told you already VB is fixed one. with respect to VB, the input is increasing and decreasing. So whenever with respect to VB, input is increasing means the voltage to input of this base of the transistor is increasing. So that emitter base junction forward bias is increases. Then that will result in the increasing of IB current. Whenever IB is increasing, IC will increase. Then whenever IC is increased, IC is passing through here, IC RC is increases. IC RC is increases. Then when IC RC increases, we are taking the output voltage, that is AC signal, across collector and ground, and this RE will not be there for AC signal, it is short circuit. So due to this capacitor, so we can say it is short circuit somewhat like this due to the presence of this capacitor. So what will happen? The VC output voltage, we can say by applying a KVL to this VC, IC, RC and the voltage across this VCE. VC is nothing but voltage across collector and emitter. That is nothing but voltage across collector and ground, because this resistor is bypass for AC signal. So VCC minus ICRC, that is equal to VC voltage. So whenever IC is increases, ICRC increases, VC will decrease. So whenever input voltage increases, input current increase, output current increase, that will result in reduce of the output voltage. So input current and output current are in phase, but input voltage and output voltage are opposite phase, out of phase for the common emitter RC coupled amplifier. So that you can see here. So whenever input amplitude is increased, input current IB increases, then when IB increases, IC increases, IC increase will decrease in the VC. Whenever input voltage decreases, then IB decreases, IC decreases, IC RC decreases, that will increase in the VC. So they are in out of phase. This case we already discussed. If this is the limit of input signal, if the input signal is again increased after beyond a limit, then some of the portion may be clipped. We may not get exact that signal. So to avoid this clipping, we have to limit the input signal. Not only limit the input signal, we have to keep Q point in the exact position. Then advantage of this RC coupled amplifier, it is almost giving constant gain over the wide frequency range. So it is suitable for audio frequency. And its cost is low. But the voltage and power gain, it is low due to effective load resistance. And the impedance matching that you will study in the higher semester, it is very low in this case. But it is widely used as a voltage amplifier. And this is the frequency response of RC coupled amplifier. Means between audio frequency range F1 and F2, it is giving high gain. Beyond these two frequency, gain is increasing. Frequency weights gain axis. So gain is decreased below the F1 and above the F2. The reason is below the F1, the coupling capacitor, the below the F1 frequency is less, means AC's frequency is decreasing. As the frequency decreases, impedance of the capacitor will increase. So this C1 and C2, this capacitance, that is increases also, its impedance increases also for this CE, its effects also will decrease. So due to that reason, the input signal may not be reached here. Also, this bypass capacitor may not be able to bypass this one. So this one gain will decrease. And above F2, what will happen? Parasitic capacitance, that will be high and the gain will decrease. So for RC coupled amplifier, it has the